If you have been diagnosed with 3PD, persistent postural perceptual dizziness, vestibular migraine, visual vertigo, or just plain feel dizzy when you are in visually busy environments or see things that move, you're going to want to listen to today's video. If you have not heard of Optokinetic training, today we are going to discover and talk about what it is, how I use it, and how you can use it to reduce your dizziness in visually stimulating environments. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Amy McMillan. I'm the creator of the channel Treat Your Dizziness at Home on YouTube, and I am a vestibular physical therapist in Northeast Ohio, and I wanted to create a channel where you can get expert advice no matter where you live and no matter what stage of recovery you're in. So with that, let's get started with our topic today. What is optokinetic training? Optokinetic training is a method that I use to treat people who have dizziness in visually stimulating places, like crowds, casinos, grocery stores, airports, anything that seems to trigger you. You might have some nausea, dizziness, or just feel off when you are in a very spatial, visually busy place. Oftentimes, some triggers that I hear from my clients are, I go to Costco and I feel nauseous and dizzy. I pull into a parking lot and try to walk across the parking lot and I feel frozen in space. I feel dizzy or uncomfortable when I see traffic moving past me and I'm seated at a red light and it's going past me. Maybe it is a ceiling fan that you see moving in the corner of your eye and you feel uncomfortable. Busy, bustling streets or restaurants make me feel kind of off or lightheaded. By no means is that list all inclusive, but those are some of the examples that I hear from my clients who do benefit from optokinetic training and suffer from dizziness that's induced by visually busy things moving around them. So why does this happen in the first place? Why would somebody feel dizzy when you are in a crowd or in a visually busy area? So the easiest way that I can explain this is you get your balance from your inner ear, your vestibular system, your eyes, and your touch system, your somatasensory. When you have an inner ear dysfunction, so maybe it's a virus or a concussion or vestibular migraine, something has caused an inner ear weakness. We call that a hypofunction. Now that could be one inner ear or both, but irregardless, the inner ear is unreliable and the brain cannot count on it. So what the brain does, it says, I need a reliable source of proprioception. I need a reliable source of sensation. So I'm going to choose the eyes. The bad part is when you are in an area or something is moving around you and the brain picks the eyes as its reliable source of information, all of a sudden, you feel like you're moving. Your brain is like, oh, I see that the fan is moving, so therefore I must be moving. And the vestibular system is not being activated when it should be. Therefore, you are feeling this sensory mismatch where you're feeling kind of lightheaded, dizzy. It's not so much of a room spin, but I have had patients with that. But it's more of just like this off sensation, kind of wonky in the head and nauseous, just unsettling, and you want to leave that area. And there's that third system that the brain isn't even accounting for at all, which is our touch system, our somatosensory. So if we were to choose our feet and our hands, we could touch a wall, we could touch a chair or a shopping cart, for example, you're probably going to feel more grounded and settled and not get as dizzy in those situations. So really, it is just a fight between our vestibular system, our eyes, and our somatosensory. And optokinetic training does just that. It decreases the dependence that we have on our eyes by focusing on our somatosensory input. Let me give you a pretty simple example to understand. Say you are in virtual reality glasses and you are in a roller coaster game. So you're seated in your chair, you have your VR glasses on, and your brain is watching this camera click up a roller coaster and then it goes down a hill. With that visual input, you're gonna feel like you're leaning back And then you're going to feel this descent. You're going to feel that in your stomach. You're going to feel like you're actually falling. That is a clear-cut example of the brain choosing the visual, even though you are seated in a chair. So it's very powerful, that visual system. So oftentimes it is hard for patients to ground and say, nope, I'm in my living room on a VR game riding a fake roller coaster. But that's really what optokinetic training is doing. It is grounding, it is utilizing our touch system, making it as strong as ever while we are watching visually busy things on a screen. So who do I use optokinetic training for? Anyone who's been diagnosed with vestibular migraines, visual vertigo, feels unsettled in visually busy areas, and 3PD after someone has developed that visual motion intolerance after a vertiginous attack. Those are all very common conditions that I would use optokinetic training for. So when prescribing optokinetic training, I instruct my clients that I use it for two reasons. One is to desensitize to a visually busy environment before you even go into it. So say, for example, you get dizzy at a Target. So we're going to pick a video that has us walking in Target. And we're almost visualizing, prepping the brain, the noises that'll be there, what it's going to look like, how to navigate. And you're just going to be able to visualize and be prepared before you even get to that location. And then two, which is the most important, is to really drive home that use of the somatasensory, our touch system. So when we are watching that video walking around Target, we are grounding and paying attention to our bodies when we are watching that video. So I use it for those two reasons, desensitize and get ready, and then two, to really drive home that somatosensory. Now, I would like to talk about a controversial topic. There are some approaches that would say to watch something that makes you dizzy, to promote that visual dependence where I'm watching something on the screen, is counterintuitive to reducing what we want, which is decreased visual dependence. All I can say is there are different approaches to treatment. As a vestibular therapist of a decade, I've used optokinetic treatment with my approach, grounding during watching these videos, to be effective in so many patient cases that I can't discount that this works. In the evidence, there is research for optokinetic training and for virtual reality training. So to have this exposure therapy, to have this desensitization and the intention of grounding while we do optokinetic videos is what makes it successful. So all I can say is there's different approaches to treatment. If this one doesn't work for you, try a different approach. But just because a different provider uses one approach doesn't discredit the vestibular therapy approach that's been used for the past decade by me and so many other providers out there. So let's talk about how to do optokinetic training. I typically use YouTube videos. So they're great because what we're looking for is a first-person point of view GoPro video, which in the description below, I will link my playlist of favorite optokinetic videos. And I will also have a purchasable download that has all of my favorite videos teed up and ready to go. That'll be in the description for you. So the first person point of view GoPro video kind of makes your brain feel like you are actually doing that movement, when in fact, what we're trying to do is ground and make sure we use our touch system to override that visual system and that what the brain is perceiving as the most reliable source of input. So on YouTube, we're going to try to pick a topic of something that triggers you specifically, whether that is walking into a football stadium, shopping at a Costco, a Target, or walking through a casino. You're going to start with a small screen and then eventually more immersive on a big screen. Also, you will start in seated and then work to standing and then a foam pad. Those are the progressions that I use. So we start in seated and we're walking around New York City streets. When you see that camera pan to the left, I need you to think, was my vision correct or did I feel like I just tipped my body to the left. And that is using your touch system to override that vision. When the camera pans up to look at a skyscraper, you're going to feel, did I just tip my weight back? Or was that just a visual trigger? You're gonna do that video anywhere from 3 to 5 minutes. I don't do anything longer than 5 minutes for multiple reasons, including electronics and screens are normally intolerable for a lot of people. So stick with that 5 minutes. If you don't have any dizziness in seated, the next day, you're gonna try that same video in standing. Feet apart is easy. Feet together is a little harder to ground. If you have no dizziness in that video, then you're gonna do it on the foam pad. Basically, we're trying to increase your symptoms just a tad, no more than 1 or 2 points. You're gonna stick with that same video until you no longer have symptoms. So the next step is you are going to try to do that in real life. You're going to be walking across those city streets and trying to ground while you are walking. And just respect what your body will give you. If it's 5 minutes before you start to feel uncomfortable, fine. If it's 20 minutes, fabulous. Each time you practice that, you'll realize that you're able to do more and more and more. And then after you have no issues with that, you pick a new video of something that bothers you, whether that's freeway driving or going to an airport so you can go on your first vacation. So now that is how I use optokinetic videos. So it's exposure therapy, desensitization, and also grounding and using your touch system over your visual system. Hopefully you found that video helpful. Remember, in the description, you will find links to my favorite playlist of YouTube optokinetic videos, and I will have my easy to follow purchasable download where I have instructions, details, and links right to my favorite videos in that description as well of this video. Thanks for tuning in. Again, I'm Amy McMillan with the Treat Dizziness at Home channel, where you can find tips and tricks on how to treat your dizziness at home.